I know so many of you are going back into the office and you guys have loved the workwear videos and you want some more outfit ideas. You want to know what you're going to wear to work. So I'm going to help you with that. And I'm going to show you in this video how to style one suit multiple ways. Welcome back to my channel. Welcome to everyone who's new here. My name is Ashley Park. Welcome to Park Avenue. I have tons of fashion content for you to check out. And if that's the kind of content you want to see, if that's what you're looking for, you're in the right place. Make sure to subscribe and make sure to hit those notification bells so that way you don't miss any of my uploads. And notification bells are kind of funny on YouTube. And I know sometimes it unsubscribes people and YouTube does all kind of things. So make sure you guys are subscribed to my channel and make sure you're hitting those notification bells so that way you don't miss anything. Now, you guys have been wanting me to do more workwear videos. You guys have been missing those. And I know so many of you are heading back into the office and you need some ideas. You haven't been in the office in a while. And I know things have changed dramatically as far as what's going on in the world. And we have to get ourselves together to get back into the office and get back into the swing of things. So this video is going to show you guys how to make one suit work for you and work really hard for you. I'm going to show you guys how to style it in multiple ways. If you get one really great suit, you're going to be able to get so many looks out of it. And this is perfect timing because you might want to revamp things, but you can't buy a ton of new pieces. This is going to be your video. So stay tuned. Now, before we get into the video, it's time for today's Instagram shout out. And today I am shouting out Dr. Lady Q. And on my last photo, she commented, "Love the outfit. Recently discovered your YouTube channel, which has become my go-to for fashion ideas. Also, just got a cute pair of denim cutoff shorts from Target. Thank you." And we love a cute pair of denim shorts from Target. And I love denim shorts. You guys already know I have been really into denim shorts this summer. I mean, like, it's a summer staple. So, you know, of course I am. But I have been loving styling them up different ways for you guys. So thank you, Dr. Lady Q. I appreciate it. Thank you guys so much. If you want to check out the photo that Dr. Lady Q commented on Instagram, then head over there and check me out. I'll have the link to my Instagram in the description box. And I'll also have the link to my Pinterest. You guys can follow me on Pinterest to get more outfit inspo. And what's cool about Pinterest is that you guys can pin my photos, because I upload individual photos of every outfit that I show you guys. You guys can pin the photos and make your own fashion boards, you know, outfit inspo, like ideas, like mood boards, things like that. And that's a great place to follow me because you can do all those things and it's just really easy to refer back to. So that way you always have a place where you can go to for like easy access to outfit ideas. So if you guys want to follow me on Pinterest, I'll have that link in the description box as well, along with all the other platforms you can check me out on. And don't forget, you guys, the closet sale is live, so you can shop updates to the closet sale. It's gonna be ongoing. So just, like, you know, save it in your favorites bar and just keep, you know, check back every so often because there'll be new things added. Probably every week, to be honest with you, because there's so many things that are being added to the closet sale that it's probably gonna be just ongoing. So just always check back there. And of course, I'll remind you guys and everything you need to know, all the information in regards to, you know, all the platforms and the closet sale is going to be in the description box. All right, so let's get into these outfit ideas. I'm showing you guys how to style one suit multiple ways, and I think this is going to be the best way to get the most out of your wardrobe. Of course, I'm always going to have some good outfit ideas for you guys and different ways to style things, but I know so many people are going back into the office and they want to refresh their wardrobe, or you might just be getting, you know, maybe you graduated college and you took some time off because of the whole situation of the world, but now you're entering into the workforce. I know companies are starting to hire. So many of you might be interviewing. There are so many different things happening right now as the world is getting back to normal. And I know so many of you need these kinds of videos. So I wanted to put together something that could just be a real lookbook for you guys, a work lookbook that uses one suit in so many different ways. So if you guys just invest in a really nice quality suit, something that is a neutral color, you will get so much wear out of it. So the suit that I wanna show you guys today is by Ann Taylor. And this is a really great suit, especially for curvy girls, because it has a four-way stretch. So the comfort is extreme. Like, it's extremely comfortable, but it's also a really nice suit. It's not too structured, but it has a really nice shape. So you don't have to worry about it being too stretchy or being, you know, too loose or like flimsy. It has a nice structure to it, even though it has that very high comfort level. Now, one thing I have noticed about workwear, and I know it's a symptom of what's happening in the world, and it's because even the stores are coming back to life again. There is so much loungewear, work from home kind of clothes, like comfy kind of clothes in these stores. Like, I have been going out to get pieces to show you guys, but there are so many things that I don't think are appropriate for work. Like if you're going into the office and you work in a very professional environment. I'm not talking about if you work in, you know, a dressy casual environment or a very relaxed office. If you work in a very professional office, there were so many things in the stores that would not work. And I could see where the struggle could be. So I know that the stores are working on getting their stock back and getting their production back and all those kind of things. So I think it's going to take a little bit of time, but I'm going to help you guys get it together. So let's just talk about this first look, because this suit from Ann Taylor is one that you can get the most out of your wardrobe with. And you'll be able to style this up until the stores come back to life, you know? But I'll make sure to give you guys more outfit ideas. But let's just get into this first look. Now, here's the first way I want to show you guys that you can wear this suit, and it's just all together, the suit with the jacket and the pants together as an actual suit. Now, what I love about suits is that you can break them up. You can wear them so many different ways. You can wear them dressy, and you can wear them casually. So the material of this suit and the fit allows it to do just that for you, and that's why I love it so much. Now, the blazer for this suit is oversized on me. I have been into a more oversized blazer, but of course you can get the size that you know works for you. Now, if you're not into an oversized blazer and you want something a little bit more tailored, maybe a little bit more fitted, you can either get an oversized size to fit the way you want it to fit as far as having the room you want, but then tailor down the parts of the suit that you feel should be more fitted. Like, for instance, this blazer. I might like the way it fits through the waist, like through the body, but then the arms are too big for me. So I would need to take those to the tailor and get them fit properly to me. But because I do dress pretty dressy casually, and I do like to have that option, and I most of the time that I wear suits or even like blazers in general, I always ruche up the arms. So for me, this is what works. But if you work in a very professional environment where you can't just crunch up your sleeves on a regular basis, I can understand that. So you might need to go take it to get tailored or size down. You know what I mean? So definitely try it out. You might have to order a few sizes, try them on, and then return the ones that don't work for you. Especially for something like a suit, you want to fit the largest part of your body and then tailor it down to be what works for you. That's not uncommon. It's really not that hard at all. I know sometimes we think, oh my gosh, I don't want to have to go get this tailored, or I spent this amount of money on it, I shouldn't have to get it tailored. But you got to remember that all of these things are mass produced. Nothing is cut to your body. And most of the time, as a curvy girl, it's not even cut for us in the first place. So we do have to work it out. We got to finagle it and figure it out. So the best way to figure it out is by ordering a few sizes if you cannot make it into the store, or some pieces might be online exclusives. Whatever the case is, you got to try on the sizes and then just take back whatever doesn't work for you. You know what I mean? But the fitting rooms are open at Ann Taylor. At least in my area, they are. So you can just try it on if you're able to go into the store. So back to this look, I want to show you guys how this suit looked all together, because of course, when you buy a suit, you want to be able to wear it all together. So very simply, I just styled it with a black camisole. This is a black with white polka dots. And camisoles are like, you have to have a camisole or a bunch of camisoles in your collection. Like I would say just a couple, just like the basic colors. You don't need a polka dot. You can do a white, a black, and then have a printed one just to have some interest. But if you stick to the neutral colors, you can just wear them over and over again. And that's also why I wanted to show you guys a neutral color suit, because the suit can be the basis for so many different looks. And if you stick to something neutral, you can wear it over and over to work, and the suit is not going to call too much attention to itself, other than the fact that it fits really well. When you pair it with other pieces, it's going to look like a totally new outfit every time you wear it. So even if you wore the same pieces 2-3 times in the work week, nobody's going to notice, because you're going to switch out the other pieces to build a whole new outfit. So I paired this suit with a polka dot camisole, and it has the lace trim, a nice, easy go-to. I usually pair blazers and camisoles all the time because I just love the way they look. The camisoles are really nice and feminine and flowy, and they also feel really cool against the skin. A lot of times you might be wearing a suit in the summertime, like right now, I think it was like 80 degrees today. So if you have to wear a suit into the office, you want to try to stay as cool as possible. So I do like to wear a camisole, especially in the summer months, but they're all year round kind of things. And you can definitely layer up. And you can transition this suit into the winter months, which is really great. The material lends itself to be able to be multi-season. I mean, obviously you can't wear it in the dead of winter if you live somewhere where it snows a lot or it's super, super cold. But you can get a lot of wear out of this. So along with styling with the camisole, I decided I was just going to pair this look with my basic black pumps from Sam Edelman. These are comfortable. They're a really nice classic style. It does have a higher heel than I would usually go for with a work shoe, but they're so incredibly comfortable that it works out. However the shoe is made, the shape, they just figured it out so that you can have a higher heel and maintain that comfort. So I really, really like that, and I definitely recommend these. They have lots of colors, and it seems like it's a brand staple for Sam Edelman, this style of shoe. So check these out if you're looking for a basic black pump. I have been looking for a basic black pump for a very long time, and I just wanted to see what was out there. I was actually going to go for a Prada pair of pumps, and I still will get those into my collection eventually. But because I don't really wear black pumps often, it wasn't something I was always reaching for. I wanted to make sure this was something that I was going to get a lot of wear out of. So I knew that Sam Edelman, because I have other pumps from them and other shoes from them, is a brand that I can trust. They were going to have something that I like. So I went ahead and got these because there are another pair of pumps that I had from them that were suede. They were a lower heel, but they were so comfortable and such like a really elegant everyday pump. So I went for these and I'm really happy with them. So check them out if you're looking for a really great priced classic pump that's good quality. So I'll have that link for you guys in the description box. But this overall look is very simple, very easy. But if you're at work and you wore something like this, first of all, you'll feel great. You'll look great. And you can trust that you're wearing something good and comfortable, so you can put your best foot forward at work. And that's very important. This is something you could wear on an interview. But of course, you can wear a white button-up shirt if you wanted to. If you felt like a camisole was just too casual for whatever the situation is, you can switch it out and wear something a lot more structured. Okay, so here's the next look, and we are breaking down the suit a little here. So I ditched the blazer to make things a little bit more casual. I wore the trousers here with a linen polo top. This top is from Banana Republic. Now, you can get a polo top from a lot of stores, and I'll link some options for you guys in the description box. But what I like about pairing a polo with this is that you get that dressy casual feel. So you can wear this into the office and still have a very professional look, even if you worked in a really, really professional office, someplace that was a little bit more strict. You could wear this outfit and, have a little bit of a dress down vibe, maybe on a Friday or, toward the end of the week. Because if you're anything like me, I usually wore more professional clothing in the beginning of the week, and then as the week decline, like went into Friday, I was more casual as the days progress. But whatever works for you. But I like this outfit because we have the comfort there, and then we're a little bit more casual and don't have to have the blazer on, and we still get a very polished professional look. And then here I am pairing the outfit again with my black pumps, and then I threw on my Pochette Matisse just to keep that very business casual professional look. I really love this bag because I can wear it in a lot of different situations. It's a great shape. I can fit a lot in it. I do tend to wear it more in the cooler months, but I would wear more deeper colors and like colors like this, what I'm showing you, like a neutral color palette on the deeper side of things into the office. So depending on your situation, you can obviously switch out for whatever bag you have. It doesn't have to be the accessories that I'm showing you here today. Besides those black pumps, you have to have those pumps, because I'm telling you guys, if you don't have a good pair of pumps, it's going to make a difference. Because before I had them, I realized that I had a huge hole in my shoe wardrobe. And now that I have them, I'm able to style so many different work looks. So check these out for sure. But this outfit is, very comfortable and casual, but you don't have to be completely suited and booted. Next up, I kept the trousers on and the black pumps. And this time I switched out the top. I'm wearing a black camisole here. And it has a little bit of like a transparent, not lace, but a mesh detail around the neck of the camisole, which adds a little bit of different, like a little bit of a different interest to the outfit, but it still keeps, a nice monochrome almost look. And then instead of the blazer, I decided to go with the denim jacket. I love styling denim with trousers for work. It gives a little bit of fun to the outfit without, going too crazy, especially, like I said, if you work in a very professional environment where you can't really do too much. A denim jacket, it still looks super polished. This denim jacket I got from Lulu's. I partnered with them a while back, and I love, love, love this denim jacket. First of all, the buttons are silver instead of copper, and I usually find that the buttons on denim jackets are like copper color, so it was cool to find one that had the silver. It is a lighter wash, which you can go with a darker wash if you wanted to, stick with a more monochrome look. A darker wash could be a little bit more sophisticated. That would be great as well. But I do like the lighter wash here because it kind of like lifts the look. And because we're wearing trousers and a black pump, and it's very sharp and put together, that denim jacket is like, you know, it's like a, wearing a leather jacket or just like a fun accessory to just change the vibe of the outfit just a little bit, but not too much. You know what I mean? I really like the way this looks put together. And then I just threw on a tote. This is my reversible Burberry tote. And of course, we love a tote bag for work because you can dump your whole life in there, all your papers, everything you need. And you could also throw a little clutch in there if you like to go out after work. And because this top that I'm wearing has that little bit of mesh, you know, once you take off the denim jacket and you need to, you know, go for some cocktails after work, you could still be cute. I mean, you would still be super polished and you would look professional, but it does have a little bit of a fun detail that would also lend itself to maybe a cocktail after work. And another thing I love about this denim jacket is that it has inside pockets. So, you know, if you have a key card or something at work, you can just put the card in the inside pocket. I just love when I find things like jackets or blazers made for women that have inside pockets because we use them too, you know. And what I do when I wear denim jackets in general, but especially with, you know, an office look, I like to just pop the collar a little bit. I always think that just makes things look more polished and it's kind of funky. It just gives a fun vibe. It looks really chic and it just looks like, you know what you're doing. You mean business about your wardrobe and it just looks really good. So very sharp. It's a nice detail that definitely changes the vibe of an outfit. It just looks really nice. It's a simple way to make a bigger statement. Here's the next look I want to show you guys. And I just simply switched out the denim jacket for a blazer. Now this is a Veronica Beard blazer. It's in a more of a rose, mauve-y sort of a shade. And it completely transformed the look. So you can get a suit look with different pieces. They don't have to be the exact same pieces that, you know, were sold together for the suit. I'm pairing these pants with a totally different blazer. I got them at totally different times, but they pair well together. So play around with some of the other blazers you have in your collection. If you decide to get this suit, you'll be able to wear it with a lot of other things. The same goes for the blazer. You can do the blazer with different bottoms. You can wear it with shorts. And I'll show you another option later on in the video, so stay tuned. But you can get so much wear out of mixing your pieces. And after you build your work wardrobe, it's gonna be an ongoing thing. But once you extend it and you build on the pieces that you have, you'll realize how much you'll get out of your wardrobe. Once you invest in like some key pieces, you can get a lot of looks out of it. Now, what I love about this blazer, I mean, it could go for any blazer, but this one in particular, it is that rosy mauve color, but it has the black button. It has a black button on it. So what I like about that is it still grounds the look, and then it looks really nice paired with this outfit. So I decided to go with my Saint Laurent puffer bag because I wanted a little bit of edge. I didn't want to do a structured bag, but I did want to keep things in the black family, and then the blazer could kind of be the star of the show. So I really like the way this all paired together. Next up, I have another very simple outfit change. Again, I just changed the blazer here and I got a totally different vibe with the look. So I'm showing you guys how you can just change one or two pieces and get a completely different look. Now, this blazer is also Veronica Beard. It's one of the scuba blazers that she has, and I love this blazer. Like, I absolutely love this blazer. And I am wearing it with the Dickie insert. I cannot tell you guys enough about this blazer and the Dickie insert. It just is such a cool piece to have. It's just so cool. The insert actually just zips out of the blazer if you want to wear the blazer alone. I like it with the insert because it gives that layered look without the bulk. You don't have to worry about, you know when you wear a sweater under a blazer, it's just very thick and sometimes it can be uncomfortable. And as a curvy girl, you don't want to add too many thick layers or any thick layers really at all because you're going to add that bulk and it could just go wrong. So I like the fact that first of all, you don't get that bulk. And second of all, you can buy a couple of these Dickies and then switch them out and get different looks without actually having to commit to, you know, that whole layered look. And that's a really nice option to have. I've seen that she's had denim ones. She's had cashmere ones. The one that I'm wearing is more like a sweatsuit material. So it's as if I'm wearing a sweatshirt underneath. And I really like the vibe. I like that it gives a casual edge to an otherwise very structured, like professional look. It's a lot of fun. And speaking of fun looks, the next outfit I have for you guys is a lot of fun as well. I decided to put the suit back on, both pieces together, the blazer and the trousers. But this time I threw on a graphic t-shirt, and this one has like a silhouette of Michael Jackson on it. It is a nice like gray color. This one I've had for a while, so I know it's not available. I'll link some other options for you guys, but you can do a white t-shirt. If you have like a white graphic t-shirt, you can do maybe something a little bit more bold, a color. That can be a lot of fun with this. You can definitely play around. If you're someone who owns a lot of graphic t-shirts, you can have fun. This suit is going to pair nicely with so many different options. So just try it out and see what works for you. But if you're into more solids, you can do any kind of neutral color top would look nice under here. And you can even do like a lighter gray if you wanted to. You can do maybe a taupe, mauve colored top. Just play around with it because there's so many looks you can pull off with this suit. And the color is so nice that it goes with so many things. And then on my feet, I just threw on a pair of sneakers. These are my Pumas. They are super comfortable. They have like a cloud foam technology, which keeps them comfortable. Now, you can either keep these in your tote bag, like if you're someone who takes transit to work, maybe you're in New York City and you have to take the train or a bus or something like that, keep them in your bag and you could like switch them out when you get to the office and throw in your pumps. Whatever the case is, you can keep them on if you want to, you know, have a more casual look. But like I said, whatever the case is, it's going to work. I think that a sneaker with a suit is, no matter how many times it's been done, it's just a look that works. It's a fun look. It's a very work appropriate look. Obviously, depending on your work environment, you might not be able to wear sneakers. So you can do a loafer. You don't have to do a sneaker. You can do a loafer and still maybe get that same casual-ish vibe, but still be very office appropriate. In Oxford, oh my gosh, an Oxford would be so cute with this look. And I actually got some DMs in the past about styling Oxfords, which is so funny because in the fall, I like go crazy with Oxfords. And there was one point where I was wearing them like just in constant rotation because I have quite a few pair. So if you wanted to achieve that sneaker look without actually wearing a pair of sneakers, a pair of Oxfords, that's going to do the trick perfectly. And maybe something with like a lug sole to get that, you know, get a little bit of an edge on it. That'll be really cute. So I'll go ahead and link some Oxfords in the description box, maybe something like patent leather, something like that. That'll be really cute. And then for my bag, I just kept on my Saint Laurent puffer bag. That bag is so fun and such like an edgy bag that it worked perfectly with this look. But you can also switch out for something else. My box bag, like a little, like a more structured bag would also look cute with this, but I just felt like the puffer was more of the vibe for me. But of course, whatever you already have, you can make it work for you. You know what I mean? Like you can definitely restyle this. Now here's the next look I want to show you guys, and it's a pencil skirt look. We love a pencil skirt. We love a pencil skirt look for every girl, especially a curvy girl. They're like magic. They just flatter the body so nicely. So all I did here was I kept that same black camisole I've been showing you guys, and then I paired it with a pencil skirt, basic black. It just pairs really nicely with this blazer from this suit that I'm showing you guys how to style. And then I kept on a black pump. And then I went with my box bag. Very simple look, but comfortable, office appropriate, and you can get so many different outfits from this. You can change out your accessories. You can do more of a brightly colored top. You can switch things out. See what you have that'll fit with this suit because I'm telling you guys, so much wear out of this. And you can even switch out the pencil skirt. Like say you wanted to wear the blazer casually, like maybe for an evening event. You want to transition this for a completely different look, like non-work related. You can throw on a pair of like black trouser shorts, you know, the shorts that are like ponte material, like more like a slack kind of a short. Oh my gosh, that would be so cute with this blazer. And it would look really good. And almost like you, it would be like creating a suit, but a shorts suit. And I love those kind of suits. I love shorts, like sets. It'll look like it came like all one piece. It'll look like it. You bought it together, but you built it. And I love that because that means you can transition it and change it around. So I love this look. And of course, you don't have to do the same bag, like I said, because this one isn't available. You can switch it out for whatever you do have. Next up, I have another monochrome look for you guys. And I am obsessed with this one. Like, I'm really obsessed with this. So the blazer, like I told you guys, is more oversized. But of course, you can get the size you want, whatever size works for you. But I do love the oversized vibe, especially paired with these pants. These trousers are from Banana Republic. And they're more like a jogger style. They have a tapered leg, but they don't have the elastic at the ankle. And that's what I find like super cool about them, because a lot of joggers and even joggers that I've had that are like slack material, they have the elastic at the ankle. And it definitely changes the vibe and it makes it less pants. You know what I mean? Like, you know, it takes away from it a little bit, but I still love those. But these are like so perfect. So these are, like I said, a jogger style, but they're tapered, but they don't have the elastic at the ankle. They do have the elastic at the waist. So you do get that comfort and it does feel like you're wearing a jogger. The waist is adjustable. You can tighten it, loosen it, whatever you need to do. It has pockets. I mean, it's just a really nice pair of pants. And then I paired it with that same tank top, like the same camisole I showed you guys in earlier outfits. It has that mesh detail, but it's just a black camisole. Any one you already have is probably gonna work. But of course, I'll link some options for you guys in the description box. And then the blazer from the suit, I'm showing you guys how to style multiple ways. I just ruched up the arms and I just really am obsessed with this look. This is like a perfect outfit. This is so, the outfit first of all was so comfortable. To like when I was wearing it, just like modeling it for you guys, it was so comfortable. I just wore my puffer like as a clutch and it was like an easy, very chic, no brainer kind of an outfit, but still very professional. And you can wear this into the office and feel really powerful. Those are the kind of looks I love because comfort is the most important for me. I mean, even though you're gonna be sitting down all day at work, or maybe not, maybe you have a very active day and you got a lot of meetings, you're gonna be walking back and forth. Either way, this is the perfect outfit for any kind of scenario you can think of at work. And I really, really enjoyed this outfit. And then for shoes, I took it back to the black pumps. You cannot go wrong with this. If you wanted to, you could wear more of a casual shoe or, you know, like just a flat shoe in general, not even more casual. You can wear an Oxford, a loafer, a pair of like Gucci mules if you wanted to do like dressy, but you know, on the casual side of things, you can switch out your footwear. And of course you could do a pair of sneakers. That would be really cute with this look as well. Now here is the last look that I want to show you guys. And this one, I wanted to show you guys how to style just a basic pair of jeans because we all love to wear jeans. And on Fridays, you might be able to wear jeans to work. So we want to get the most out of those as well. Now the blazer, I'm wearing the same blazer from the suit, the same black camisole that I have been showing you guys over and over throughout this video. And then my cheeky straight jeans. If you're new here, even if you've been watching, even if you just found me last week, like, I wear these jeans all the time. I have several washes in these cheeky straight jeans from The Gap. I wear them over and over constantly. And one cool thing about this particular wash is that they don't have any rips, any tears. There's one little like bit of distressing on the back of the jeans, but overall, these are perfect for the office. Like I said, if you work in a very business professional environment where you can't really, you know, experiment too much or you know, be too loud or do anything too crazy with your work wardrobe, these jeans are perfect. And even if you can, even if you work in a very casual work environment, sometimes it's just nice to have jeans without any rips in them. So these are perfect. They have a nice high rise, they have a good amount of stretch, but they're sturdy. You can sit for hours in these and be comfortable. You can wear them on the weekend, style them in different ways. I love these jeans. They have a finished hem, which I love because so many jeans have raw hems right now. So it's nice to have a finished hem on a pair of jeans. They're cropped so you can wear them with pumps, sneakers, mules. I mean, so many ways to wear this jean and I have styled it so many times for you guys. And it's really just because I love them. They have a button fly. They're a really great pair of jeans. So if you're looking for something for the office, these are it, but you can also wear these on the weekend. And then I threw on my Gucci mules. These are the black ones. I'm wearing these because it just worked well with this entire outfit, but I could also do my cream ones. I have a pair of camel color ones that could go with it as well. So you can try different colors here, you know what I mean? But these Gucci loafers, definitely invest in these if you want an option like this for your workwear. If you feel like something is missing, you want that, you want a flat shoe that can elevate things that maybe it's just a different style than a basic flat. These are a good option. When I wear these, I do think it adds like a little bit of a preppy vibe to my outfit. I really like that. They're very comfortable. And if you live somewhere where you're walking a lot, like you know, live in New York City where you take transit to work, you're just on your feet a lot. If you take these to the cobbler before you wear them, you're gonna get to wear these so for a long time. You're gonna get a lot of life out of them. The leather's really nice. And what I find about these is that the more I wear them, the more I break them in. To me, that wear and tear on them, it looks more appealing. It looks, has that worn look, but the shoe holds up really nicely. The leather is really nice. And like I said, if you take them to the cobbler, take them to the shoe cobbler immediately after you purchase them and put one of those rubber soles at the bottom and a tap on the back on the heel, you're gonna have them for a very, very long time. And if you want some other tips and ideas on how you can maintain and extend the life of your wardrobe, I did an entire video on that. So I'll link it in the cards and I'll also have it in the description box for you guys. But it's a really great like reference guide if you want some ideas or, you know, some things maybe you knew in the past and you kind of like forgot about it. That video is a really great reference. So that is it, you guys. Those are some ways you can style this really amazing suit from Ann Taylor. And of course, that is not where it ends. There are so many different ways you can style this that I didn't show you. You can do like a white button-up shirt. You can do a pop of color. You can do a white t-shirt. Like so many more options, different shoe options, different handbag options. You know, you can add a brooch to the blazer. I mean, you can, the opportunities are endless here. I thought it was a really great basic staple suit to have in your collection. Like I said, if you're going back into the workforce, if you are just entering the workforce, if you're looking for a job, maybe you're interviewing, this suit is a really great one to have in your collection, and you're gonna get so much wear out of it. Ann Taylor does have the blazer in another style, and they had some other pants that were similar, like different lengths. So I'll link all the things that Ann Taylor has, all the cute stuff that I think you guys will really, really like and you might wanna check out. So I'll link all that in the description box. And if you guys have any questions, of course, leave it in the comments. Let me know if you found this video helpful. Let me know if you got some good ideas from it. And let me know in the comments what's going on with you guys. You know, are you looking for workwear? Are you shopping work pieces? Are you looking for suits? What's going on? I know I've asked you guys in the past if you were heading back in the office, and a lot of you told me that you were, but I know some of you are also still figuring things out. So let me know in the comments. If you have any questions, drop that in the comments as well. If you haven't subscribed already and you made it this far, what are you waiting for? I would love to have you. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up. And that's it, you guys. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.